In Japan, where coffee sales surpass green tea, Hayato Kameyama keeps profits percolating. 8 years of growth, even during the financial crisis 6 years ago. But this year, it's a really tough time, he says. The Japanese yen is at a seven-year low. Prices are rising in this island nation that relies heavily on imports, like Kameyama's coffee beans. I'm paying 30 to 50% more, he says. It's really cutting into my profits. On top of higher prices, higher taxes are scaring away customers. A national sales tax hike in April pushed Japan into a surprise recession. Fearing more economic damage, Prime Minister Shinzo Abe delayed a second tax hike, only to have credit rating agency Moody's downgrade Japan, citing its huge debt. With problems piling up, Abe's taking a political gamble, calling a snap election 2 years early.
This election is extremely significant.
Longtime Asia strategist Keith Henry calls it a highly calculated move. The prime minister can call an election at any time, and right now, his opposition is in disarray. Henry and many other analysts say even if his party loses seats, Abe is all but guaranteed to stay in power.
He needs more time.
A win gives Abe 4 more years to execute Abenomics, flooding the market with cash, increasing government spending, pushing private investment. The goal? Reverse nearly 2 decades of deflation and stagnation.
In a sense, what you have to do is stimulate the Japanese people and bring hope to them.
There are bright spots. Japan has low unemployment. Stocks hit a 7-year high. Home mortgage rates are less than 1%.
You're 27 years old,
yes.
Already a homeowner.
Yeah.
Things are going well.
Yeah, that's right.
Kenshi Ebihara says he's benefiting from Abenomics, but even he worries about Japan's shrinking, aging population. The stock market is up, he says, but in the long term, I don't think the Japanese economy is getting better. We have a lot of social problems, and I'm not sure Abenomics is the solution. Right now, it's the only solution lawmakers are offering to address Japan's problems, giving voters little real choice as they weigh in on their nation's financial future. Will Ripley, CNN, Tokyo.